Good afternoon. Welcome to Channel 48 on the Monday, the 1st of October. And today I like to present to you Lindroid version number 3 with audio built in. Welcome back. Today I love to present to you Linux Mint 17.3. That was transformed to look like, you know,
Lindroid.
And I teamed it a bit and made it really beautiful, updated to V3. And in V3, we also updated to 17.3. So the 3, in fact, is the third version of Linux Mint. Yeah, V3, 17. And it's 32-bit. Yeah, well, not 64, it's 32-bit. It must run on any PC, yeah, 64 and 32-bit, and the coolest of it is it has audio built in. So how to get started, what do you need and what to do? You will find a link in my description whenever it's there or in the comment section, and then just download it. It's an ISO file. You will be downloading it from Google. Just copy it to your Google Drive so you also have it, you know, so you don't need my link all the time, so you can go straight up to whatever, and you can also share it from there, you know. Go ahead, share this, because this is for it's effect to motivate Linux developers to create a build from source, yeah, that will have this built in. And the way that I created it will in fact help also users on devices with less high specifications. As you could see, we did this on a 1 GB Intel Centrino, old, very old Fujitsu stylus stick, and everything worked very beautiful, better than ever expected. So what will you need? You will need of course the ISO file. And then the ISO file, you will have to burn it to a CD or to a bootable USB. You can, with some tools like Unet Bootin, or you could use Power ISO. I use Power ISO 4.9 all the time to create my bootable USB sticks. And if I have a Linux machine available, Linux Mint, just go in the search, type USB, and you will find the image writer. Just select that one, you know, select the ISO. Select your USB thumb drive and the USB stick will be created. So when you have that and you have a PC that you want to effect transform into
a Lindroid system.
Yeah, a Linux system that also has Android built in, a system that will let you choose depending on your mood, whatever you want to use today, if it's going to be Android or if it's going to be Linux. The difference is that the Android that will run on your device will run on its own. So you will have all the hardware resources available to feed that Android. That's why it was also working on a 1 GB system. Have you ever heard of Android Oreo running on a 1 GB system? No, but here it does. So I'm gonna bring you closer and let's just get started and let's get this thing done. Okay, there we are. This is the tablet and we're gonna turn it on. And you will see that we changed the operating system. It's updated to V3. And I'm not sure if it's the best thing for it. Of course, this is an older device. Okay, and here you can see that we can choose whatever we want to boot. Okay, if you don't do anything, it's gonna boot out of itself. And the boot animation was also updated. And this is in fact the Android Linux Tux. It's a green Tux, meaning that this Tux has Android built in. Okay, so this is the new Tux for our system. Maybe it will get a shirt with a little Android logo in it. This is the login screen, and as you can see, it's saying Lindroid user identify to continue. So the password for the system will be for you channel 48. Okay, my system has a different password because I already installed it. So whenever you're gonna install it, you're then gonna of course change the password into something else. I don't want all your users to use the same password. Okay, it's a private system, it's your system, and you will have to create your own password. And you're gonna do that whenever you're gonna install it. This is the system, it's booting up. The looks stayed kinda the same, but also changed a bit, updated, as you would expect from an update. As you can see, we have a new My Computer icon. It's called Drives. As you can see, the home, it looks familiar, but if you take a better look at the home, you're gonna see this thing has doors and windows. It's it's a very advanced house. Okay, and of course the icon pack that was powered by my friends from GitHub. So we have again a beautiful Lindroid system with, of course, here on top reminding you that this is Lindroid OS. Okay, you're gonna have a little tux there, and we're in Linux, so it's showing the Linux tux. All right, and tux is of course the little penguin we're talking about. And this is the system, how it looks. Again, very colorful, done under Mate, and yeah, it's working really nice. What do you have inside? In sound and video, you have OpenShot video editor, rhythm box. I added simple screen recorder, I added for you. And KDEN Live, that's another fantastic video editor. Okay, I also added Gparted for you, so you won't be having to look for that whenever you're gonna install the system and need to repartition the drives. That's all installed. Wine is installed, and yeah, I will have to redo the writing, because in fact I just updated the boot animation, and now I'm kind of happy about it. So in fact now I can go ahead and make a new version here on the desktop. As usual, you will have a little manual that will welcome you. This is a noob setup. This is, I think everyone can in fact do this. Okay, I try to explain it in really simple words, whatever you need to do. I didn't use any expensive word. Okay, and it should be understandable for each and everyone. You will read it whenever you downloaded it. I'm not gonna reveal everything what's in there. So what more can you expect? Well, it's 17.3, and as you can see, we are fully updated, so your system is up to date. That's just how you're gonna receive it as well. Of course, if you're gonna install this some months after the release, then you will have updates, and then you will do some updating again, and yeah, that's it. So Linux Mint will keep updating your system, so you can use this up to, I think, 2019 or 20, not sure. So let's go ahead and restart the system now in Oreo, and for this I will have to put in a little USB stick from Eminent. I advise everyone who like to do these kinds of testings, to bring more functionality to their devices. Don't only depend on the hardware that was built in, because sometimes it will just not be supported. So there we go. Booting Android. And all credits for this Android build was by Mr. C.W. Huang. He's the maintainer and creator, so it's fantastic to have a site like Android apostrophe x86 to even exist and to bring us all sorts of versions of Android that we can install onto our x86 devices, our PCs, MacBooks. So that's really, really nice. Even though I'm saying MacBooks, not every MacBook will accept this, because some old, very old MacBooks, they don't support these kinds of things. They don't support nothing. So there we are, and this is the Android, this is Android 8. So let's go into the settings. Let me show that to you. You see that? System, about the tablet, and you should be able to read it, Android 8.1.0. It's the Fujitsu tablet, the ST5112, even though it's not the 5112, it's the 5110. And here you can see that the kernel was by Mr. Huang at Android x86, number one. He's the number one developer of this thing. So yeah, respect to Mr. Huang. So yeah, big up to Mr. Huang. Of course, you can also pull up the menu. As usual, I disabled the Google services and the Play Store again, because yeah, it was really making this system lag, and it was busy with other things, and my little USB stick could not handle all that data, and it would result in a system that would hang and not do whatever I wanted to do. So I just kicked that out. Now we take a quick look at my previous build of Linderoid, and here we are in the Android environment. And as you can see, this kind of looks like Windows 10. Hey, my mouse is not on. Why? Oh, of course, it's connected to the other things there, but here it is. And as you can see, a beautiful system in the Windows 10 style, really great for desktops. You see that? It even has a phone. Let me see where my phone is, because I should be able to make phone calls with this thing. Phone should be here somewhere, I think. Phone, there it is. So if I log on to the phone, I have an account in here, so I can immediately make phone calls and receive phone calls. I have a inbound number. I'm gonna call the post office as usual. You see that? So we also have a phone, a desktop phone, and it works. There you go. You hear that? But I can also receive calls, eh? I can also receive calls. So if you call this number, if you know my number, my VoIP in number is just a landline number. You can just call me with a normal phone or with a GSM. So this is in fact what you can make from the Android. This is just Android. This is Lineage OS, the previous build that you were looking at. Of course, it's not about this build. So I'm getting some power there, and let's put it in. You will need for this project a refit bootable USB stick. And for those that don't know what that is, find videos in my list. And make sure that you put the refit, very important, in the first USB. And the second one will have the operating system. Very important, okay? Because otherwise it will not boot. This is a 32-bit MacBook. At least it has a 32-bit BIOS. And even though it runs Leopard Snow, this thing is 32-bit official. You don't have to do anything. It's gonna boot from the first stick. You see that? And now we're just gonna boot into the system. And let's see if everything went right. And here we can hit enter to boot the system. And if everything goes good, we should see our new Tux, our green Tux, meaning Android is also available in the system. And we wait for it to boot. This might take a second. You see that? Just look at the USB stick. If it's flashing, then you will only worry if your name is Adam Curry. But if it's not, hey, don't even worry, my friends. My friends and girlfriends. Of course, females are also looking. Eh? This is not only guys. This is not only the guy channel. This is also for the ladies, you know, the ladies. My ladies. And there you go. There it is. And you can see that this is really... you can see that this is something different, eh? This is not some small little thing that is, this is Tux, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Tux, Atux. And of course you're gonna type, you must first type your username, you must identify, eh? You must identify. So you're gonna type Lynn the Right. You see that? That's what you're gonna type. And for the password, you're gonna type channel 48. Okay, muy bien. So we are booting up and we are almost there. And then now you're gonna also see the beautiful new, in fact, updated desktop. It has different icons than version 1. Version 1 icons were by iPauly. And in fact, this is from powered by the guys from Boomerang. So yeah, you have a nice icon pack. Nothing was installed via the terminal. This was just updated without installing. So you don't have crazy things that are installed in this system. It's a lovely system. As you can see, it looks really good. Everything is available. I'm really happy to see that. So is the Wi-Fi working? Yes, Wi-Fi is working. So let's connect to the Wi-Fi. We're connected to Wi-Fi in a second here. You see that? Boom, look at that. Oh, connected. Vous êtes connecté, monsieur. So the first thing that we of course gonna do is we're gonna hit Gparted, GP, again, as usual. Hey, there you go, Gparted. Put in the password again of the system that is for now still channel 48. Without capitals. Okay. Just hit ignore. Up here, we're just gonna say goodbye, delete. And we delete the X4, boom. And we say Roger D there. Yes, apply, please. Close. And ignore. That is the USB error that is hosting the operating system that we're gonna install. So now we're gonna say partition and then a new partition. This system, let's first take a look at the system, what it is. So we go to system tools and then to system monitor. And we first gonna see what it is. This thing has 1.9 gigabytes of RAM. So it's 2 gigabytes. So we're gonna just type in here 2000. Yeah? And then you say add. So here we have a partition of
296 gigabytes and here one from 2000 megabytes. So we're gonna say file, create new, new. And this one here will be mastered as Linux Swap, remember? So we have a Linux Swap and an X4 partition and we give a Roger D there. And in fact now we are ready. After this we will be ready to install the operating system. So we're gonna close this. We just give an ignore there. Okay, and we're gonna go and type sys, and then you're gonna find it here, system back. Okay, go ahead, select system back, and up here you're gonna select system install. Okay, and I'm gonna call this how shall we call it, Mac. No, Lindroid Mac. Okay, Lindroid Mac. Username will be Lindroid. Looks nice. Password. Password is of course personal. And up here, as host, I'm just gonna give it Lindroid. Okay, next. So here are the partitions that we created, the X4. We're gonna mount it as root. And we hit the little arrow there, so it's been confirmed. The 1.9 gigabytes, we will select swap. Okay, and we give it a little Roger D there. Now, very important here, remember this part that I told you about. It's saying transfer user configuration files. If you don't select this, then it will not work. Okay, and now we hit next. It say install system using following restore point and say start. So that is exactly what will happen now. And the system will be installed to the Mac. And in meanwhile, I'm gonna do some push-ups and the dishes, and then I'm gonna get back to you whenever this process is done. Alrighty dokey, we're almost there. And the system is installed to the Mac. And next thing that we're gonna do is simply reboot LastSystem. Here you can see successfully installed, no errors or whatsoever, and the complete installing time took about 5 minutes. And we say shut down. We're gonna shut down the system. Goodbye. Beautiful, eh? This is, you can see this thing has balls. Okay, and now we're gonna turn on La Bebe. Ding, you hear that? That particular Mac sound is a real Mac. This is not fake Mac, this is a real Mac. We just wait, we see the apostrophe there, and we can see that Android 8.1 was also integrated, but of course must first be enabled. So we're gonna enable it now. We're booting up 17.3 for the first time after the install, and soon we will be greeted by the Linux Android Tux. This is in fact the new Tux, and this Tux will be the Tux that will in fact reveal the viewer and the user that this system is not just only a Linux system, it also has Android in some way built in. And most of you guys are running these fantastic systems from these days with i5, i7, and I don't know how much i's. But yeah, you guys have different versions. Huh? I mean, like a virtual for me is not counting. I don't want to run Android in Linux. No, it's or Android or Linux. Username will be Lindroid. Oh, I'm typing on the wrong keyboard. Don't you hate it? So, Lin Droid. Okay, I just installed it, so my password is something else. So you must not forget to, you know, don't forget your password. Because if you forget your password, then you can start all over again. I would not know how to bypass that. In Windows, we can bypass it in different ways, but not with Linux. At least, not that I would know how. I never looked into that yet. Probably if I look into it, I will find out how to do it. But at this point, je ne sais pas. So don't forget your password, okay? System is booting up. And we see that everything is available. The little icons, no more changing around of icons and these things. Only thing that, oh, there it is, Ducky. And you can see that Ducky got the leopard duck instead of the square duck that everybody has these days with their Macs. You know, we're back to Steve Jobs look and feel. So, in fact, Steve Jobs is also, in fact, his... Well, maybe I should say was and Steve, their thoughts are also in the system. You all know I'm a Mac. I love Macs and the look and feels, especially from Macs. I love that very, very, very much. As you can see, it also is kind of in the style. So this MacBook will not feel bad at all to run this beautiful looking operating system. Okay, it does not have to go back in look and feels. Look and feels goes together with beauty, you know, and with dignity. So it's not always when you see nice woman that she has bad personality. Sometimes you also have beautiful woman with very good personality. These people exist, really, trust me. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna enable Android now. And we're gonna just simply go to the terminal, the little black icon beside the bin. I can understand that some of you don't know what is terminal if you're new into this project. And you're gonna type CD and then capital D O downloads. So what we're saying here is we're changing the directory. Yeah? We're changing the directory to downloads. So now it's changed into downloads. So now we're gonna type sudo, that means root. Yeah, it will sudo as well as for a password. Sudo and then alien. Yeah, you see that? Alien, space, and then apostrophe, psi. I showed this in the previous video before, but I'm gonna do it with all my builds because C, you see that? CI, and then space, and then the name of our Android distribution. Here it is, downloads. Here it is. And we're gonna right mouse click. On your Mac, that will be two fingers on the tab. This is right mouse click. You see that? If you only have one finger on it and you're gonna click that, it will not work. You see, you must put two fingers on it and then you're gonna get the right mouse click. So two fingers, right mouse click, and then you type rename. And then again, right mouse click, and then copy the name. Okay, you need the exact name. You are already in the directory, so it's telling Alien to go inside the Android x86 8.1 Oreo. You see that? And now we hit enter. So it's gonna ask for the password. You type the password and now it's push up time. So I'm gonna do the dishes a little bit and clean the kitchen. I suggest you do the same thing. And when this process is done, it's just gonna stand there for the next 10 minutes, depending, as I said, on your processor speed. And when this is done, I'm gonna get back to you. And then we're gonna reboot the system into Android.
Okay, so the system is done. We can see that there are two lines saying that it could not copy blah, 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 nonsense, rubbish. Don't worry about it. Let's just go ahead and reboot La System. Let's just turn it off, and then we're going to turn it on again, and then we're going to reboot into Android.
We shut down the machine, we power it off. Okay, and I know why I'm telling you to power it off first and then turn it on again. Oh. Bonjour. That is one beautiful tux. I love it.
Okay, now all you need to do is select Android 8 x86 and just boot it up. As you could see, under the Android x86, we also have a debugging mode. Let's say if for any reason your Android is not booting up or it restarts the computer whenever you select the x86 Android 8.1, simply select the debug mode and run the debug mode, and at the end just type exit, and then the system will start up, and this is what you then will see. The first boot up, of course, as usual, will take a little bit longer, so at this time I say go do 20 more push-ups.
Wow, look at that, there we are. And I'm just gonna use my mouse. Oh, my mouse is not connected. Let's use this mouse then. We're gonna start.
Now, because of my Wi-Fi stick that was recognized by Android, I will be able to hit skip, as you can see. Okay, and that's only because the Wi-Fi stick was found. If you have no Wi-Fi stick that is found in that particular part, then you're not gonna pass the screen. Okay, so make sure you have a Wi-Fi stick that is supported by Android. I'm gonna call this MacDroid, and I think that's a nice name. So let's go ahead, and as you can see, Google Services is installed, and yeah, we will, if everything goes the way I expected, immediately get some errors from the Google Play. Ah, there it goes. You see that?
Don't worry about this, Google Play Store. I'm gonna disable it immediately, because in fact I want to use this system without Google Play Store. So we're gonna go for Launcher 3. That is an updated Pixel Launcher, of course. And there we go. Oreo is running and up on the system. You see that? And let me show that to you. Let's go into the settings. I'm first gonna turn off some stuff. So I'm gonna go to you see that Google Play Service. I hate it when I get these errors. So we're gonna go to device admin apps. Okay, I'm gonna turn that off and then deactivate device admin, otherwise I cannot turn off the Play Service. And then I go back and we go one back. I'm gonna find our applications if I can. System one back. Oh, can't even find my applications. Finish setup. Klaar. Wegwezen. What is this? No. Never. Apps. Oh, this mouse is not sweet to work with. Apps, see all 23. Takes a second. Okay, and now we can find the services, Google Play services, 62 megabyte. Gonna disable it and I'm gonna force stop it. Okay, we go one back with the escape. Google Play Store, disable. I'm doing this because I have my own apps, okay? So I don't want to use apps that I already have. And I don't want no speech apps on here because these things are 24/7 listening what is happening. I have my own YouTube app. I use a YouTube mod that will let me use YouTube without the Google Play services. And we have a little stuck up here. Okay, clear catch. So in fact, now we are in fact ready to use the system. Don't forget that you also have a great privacy guard. Many of you don't use that. You can use it by finding the privacy. What is this? Oh, there is no privacy guard in here. This is not Linux OS. So I'm very sorry about that. So yeah, if you're not cool with that, then you must wait for the next build that will soon arrive on Linux Mint 18, because we arrived at 18. We went through all the effects 17.1, I mean version 17, 17.3, and now we're gonna make a step to 18 in the next build. So yeah, system is running up, only Wi-Fi. What's up with the Wi-Fi? I have no Wi-Fi. Probably that was because, oh, there is the Wi-Fi. Oh my goodness, we have Wi-Fi, so we can connect to the internet at least. Okay, so we're gonna connect to the internet, Wi-Fi, and boom, we are connected, guys. That's just how simple it is.
Wow, that was again a very long video, but I'm sure that was kind of helpful and useful. And of course, if it was, leave it a like, subscribe to my channel if you did not already, hit the notification bell so you will be updated whenever I upload a new video again. This was my Lindroid V3 and we installed it on the MacBook, and as you could see, it was the same thing as installing it on any other x86 system. Remember, this is 32-bit, so it will also work on 64-bit systems. I want to say thank you to Linux Mint. Thank you to Mr. Juan for, of course, the Android. Yeah. Thank you to Alien developers, the Kiemu developers. Thank you so much for your time and effort and making this possible. Enough thanks to System Back. Respect to you, brother. And I'm really happy that you rised out of your sleep again. So you got out of your winter sleep. And yeah, we can expect great things, because now we can also do this on Linux Mint 19. Thanks to that developer waking up out of his sleep. So welcome back. And to you all, I want to say, have fun with the system, share it with your friends. You can install this on any computer, it's open source, and you can share it with your friends. So give it away, do something beautiful and make me proud, okay? And of course, to the Linux developers and development world, I would like to request something like this, you know, build from source and yeah, easy to use and not demanding to run in a virtual environment, so it will run natively on the system standalone. In that case, yeah, everything will be great, because then we will finally have a Linux distribution that has Android built in. At this time, there's no such thing like that, at least I could not find anything. Maybe there is, but I don't know. So if there is, please send me a download link so I can test it out. But my download link of this, what I think is the first Linux distributions with Android built in, you can download from out the command section. You will find a link that is pinned with a message about this. So go ahead, download it. Thank you for watching and love to see you in the next video again. Until then.